travel and timing issue, we're going to switch the order of the next two talks. So the next talk is entitled More Objective Assessment of Tumor Regression in Post-Neoadjuvant Therapy Resections in Pancreatic Ductal Adenocarcinoma, a multicenter study on comparison of multiple tumor regression grading systems. Okay?
Thank you, Chairman. Good morning, everyone. This is my COI. Increasing number of patients with pancreatic cancer has been treated with neoadjuvant therapy. So this is prognostic factors of UICC. Pathologic response to neoadjuvant therapy is new and promising prognostic factor. Pancreatic cancer showed various pathological changes. For example, necrosis of cancer cells, degenerative cancer cells in fibrous tissue, or macrophage infiltration, degenerative vascular vessels. Pathology assessment on tumor regression may be important to predict patient outcomes. There are two commonly used grading systems to assess tumor regression. Another system has been recently introduced by JPS. This is a summary of pathologic grading systems of Evans, CAP, and JPS. They focus on proportion of viable and non-viable cancer cells. CAP and JPS require estimation of pre-existing tumor area and then evaluate proportion of remnant cancer cells. But there are several problems in these systems, for example, reproducibility. So this study shows reproducibility of CAP and Evans and MD Anderson scores. Blue indicates discrepancy case by four pathologists. So Evans and CAP systems fail to show reproducibility. Another problem is prognostic utility. So previous study have shown that very nice correlation between prognosis and grading systems. For example, Evans over 2B was correlated with better prognosis. However, in our previous studies, we did not find any correlation between prognosis and pathologic grading systems. However, we found that encapsulating fibrosis and ART showed correlation with prognosis. So what is ART? ART is area of residual tumor. We evaluated ART using an image software. So patients with ART under 220 millimeters square showed better prognosis than others. However, CAP did not show any correlation with prognosis. The reproducibility and the prognostic relevance of pathologic grading systems have not been well demonstrated. ART may be useful, but it may not be practical. So we propose a new and simple and semi-quantitative ART grading system based on the number of microscopic fields. In this study, we compared the clinical relevance between ART and other tumor regression grading systems. ART is based on the number of microscopic fields. 1/4x objective lens field is equivalent to 23 millimeter square. Score 0 is no remaining cancer cells. Score 1, less than 1 field. 2, between 1 and 2. 3, between 2 and 3. 4, over 3 fields. This shows analysis of ART. So white line indicates cancer. Blue line indicates 4x objective lens field. So cancer area within one field, so this is score 1. Cancer area within two fields, so this is score 2. Cancer area within three fields, so this is score 3. Cancer area within cancer area over three fields, so this is score 4. The patient cohort was 97 pancreatic cancer patients. Median age was 66. Most of them are borderline resectable. They treated with GS, with radiotherapy or GS. Most of them were stage 2 or 3 tumors. Two pathologists evaluated Evans CAP, JPS, and ART grading systems. And inter-observer concordance between two pathologists were evaluated. If there was a discrepancy between two pathologists, the third pathologist decided the final grade. And we compared the correlation between final grades and survival. In this study, we divided into two groups, high and low grade regression, like this. This shows results. Two pathologists evaluated each grading system independently. White box indicates low grade regression grade. Green box indicates high grade regression grade. So most of patients were in low grade regression group. So it suggests that poor response in this cohort, most of them borderline resectable, treated with GS-based chemotherapy. As for individual scores, Evans 2A, CAP1, JPS2, and ART2 showed lower agreement compared with others. Among them, JPS2, the lowest agreement, because JPS require evaluation of both tumor bed and tumor cell proportion. This shows inter-observer concordance of four tumor regression grading systems. ART showed the highest percentage of agreement and kappa value, so suggesting that ART system is very simple, and so it led to higher reproducibility. This shows result of overall survival. High regression grade group, so purple and red line showed longer overall survival as compared to low regression grade. However, there is a significant overlap. Among them, ART showed better results. Recurrence-free survival also showed similar results. Next, we divided into two groups. Blue line indicates low-grade regression group. Red line indicates high-grade regression group. So, as we expected, high-grade regression group showed better prognosis than low regression grade group. Among them, ART showed statistically significant differences between two groups. Recurrence-free survival also showed a similar result. ART showed significant differences between two groups. In summary, the inter-observer concordance of ART was higher than those of other grading systems. Smaller ART grades were significantly associated with longer recurrent-free survival and overall survival. In conclusion, ART-based tumor regression grading system was more objective and prognostic than Evans, CAP, and JPS systems in this study. ART-based grading system may become the standard method to assess tumor regression in post-neoadjuvant resection for pancreatic cancer. Thank you for your attention.
So this abstract is open for questions. Yes.
Thanks very much for your work. It's terrific. And I do think we need to to refine this more. We had an experience where this patient had about a 75% decrease in the tumor size and was resected, and then the path report came back with a grading system that said there was no treatment effect. And so we sat down and started thinking about this, and we think maybe what we need to add in is some other clinical parameters to the pathologic readout, and that would really enhance the ability of this to predict for prognosis. And I wonder what you think about that.
Thank you for your questions. So we think so reproducibility and easy way is very important. So we think it is important to we can use routine pathological specimens for daily practice.
Yeah. Yes.
Hi, I'm a co-author of the this study. Actually, I talked about that with my radiation oncologist at MGH. And he suggested that we should include the clinical factor to the assessment of the pathology response. But the issue is that the comparison of the first imaging study and preoperative imaging study, we are not sure how much of the residual tumor or actually entire tumor is tumor or fibrosis. There are many factors we have to think about. So, I mean, actually, ideally, yes, if we can incorporate clinical factors, you know, select clinical factors to assess the response, that's great, but we have to be very, very careful about it. Yes, that's shown that our Panama study from MGH.
Great. All right, thank you so much.